Welcome back! In today's video, I'll be showing you how to download, install, and set up OBS on a Windows 11 PC or laptop. OBS is a free piece of software that will allow you to record your screen, as well as live stream and add image overlays. I'll have even more videos in the future showing you how to do even more in OBS, such as add an overlay to the screen. If you are downloading a different version of OBS, such as the Streamlabs version, then the installation and setup process will be very similar, so you can still follow this video. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the method. We'll start by downloading OBS. I'll leave the official link in the description, and this is up to date at the time of recording this video. Just double check that you are on the correct link though, as I'm not responsible if you go to the wrong place. Once the page loads, it should look something like this, and if you're watching in the future, it could look a bit different. Feel free to have a look around on the site to get familiar with the features of OBS, and once you are ready to download, find and click on the Windows Download button. Depending on your browser, the download might begin automatically, or you might need to choose a location to save the downloaded file. The location you save it in doesn't really matter as long as you can access it easily, so the Downloads folder is perfect. Allow the download to complete, and once it has, click on the file to open it. You will now probably need to click on Yes on the user account control screen to begin the installation. The installer window should now open, and the first page provides you with basic information, so click on Next. Now you should see the user agreement screen. Click on Next once you have read it to continue with the installation. On the next page, you need to select a location to install the software to. The default location should be fine, although it doesn't matter too much as long as you remember roughly where it is and that you make sure it's not installed within a folder that might get deleted accidentally, such as the Downloads folder. Click on Install once you have chosen the location. The installation will now begin, and it shouldn't take too long to complete. After the installation is done, the final page will load and you can select the box to open OBS when you click on Finish. Allow OBS to load up, and once it has, we'll look at setting up and customizing the software. When the software opens, you should see a preview of the screen. If you don't see this, click on the plus icon in the Sources section and then select Display Capture. Give the source a name, for example Main Monitor, and then click on OK. Choose the monitor or input you want to use from the drop-down box, and then click on OK again. Don't worry if the preview doesn't seem to fit on the screen, as this might change later when we edit a few of the settings, but if you want, you can drag it to the correct shape. You can follow this exact method to add a different source, for example you can add a game capture or an image overlay by choosing image. The mixer section to the right of sources is where you can check your mic volume and also the volume of your PC that it will record. You will be able to customize and change some of the audio settings later on once we look in the main settings. To the left of the sources section is where you can create a scene if you want to do that. You can also add and create transitions here that you might find helpful when live streaming. Feel free to have a play around with these. Let's move on to looking into the settings. We'll be able to make changes to things like the recording and streaming quality and much more. Click on Settings under the Controls section on the right side to open up the settings. We'll start in the General Settings. There isn't much to change in here, although you might want to have a look down the list to see if there are any specific things you want to have. Most of these are personal preference, and you will probably want to fine-tune these once you begin using OBS more in the future. Use the list on the left to access each part of the settings, so now let's look in the Stream Settings. Again, there isn't much in here, but this is where you can link your stream. I'll have future videos that will show you how to set up your stream in OBS to stream onto YouTube and Twitch, but essentially, what you need to do is either connect your account you want to stream and follow the steps, or get the stream key from the site profile on Twitch or YouTube, for example, and connect it that way. The next section of the settings is called Output. We can change a lot of the quality settings in here for both streaming and recordings. You can change the stream quality settings at the top. These will depend on your internet connection, and you will probably want to test this out to find out what works best for you, as if you increase the quality too much, your stream will lag. Below the stream quality settings, you can change some of the recording settings. The first option is the location that the recorded files will save to. This is important, and you will want to make note of this location or customize it so that you can easily access your files once you have finished recording. You can also change some of the quality settings of the recorded files in here too, as well as the file type. These are up to you, and if you're unsure about what all of the options mean, then I would recommend having a look at the advantages and disadvantages of each file type. It's worth checking on your editing software what file types you can use and what are best to help make this decision also. Some editing software might not allow certain video file types. Let's move on to the next settings tab, which is audio. In here at the top, you can change the audio quality or sample rate and also the channels. You might want to match this to the audio that you are inputting, for example from your microphone. Below this, there are more settings and you can add or change the audio devices that you can use on your recording or stream. You will then need to edit these further in the audio mixer preview section that we looked at earlier. The next part of the settings focuses on the video. The resolutions you can choose on here will probably depend on the performance of your PC. You can set the base resolution to the resolution of your monitor if you want, and the output resolution to the resolution you want to stream or record in. If this is set too high, it will likely impact the performance of your PC. There are a few types of scaling options to choose too that can impact the quality of the outputted file or stream when downscaling. The frame rate is again up to you, but of course the higher this is, the more resources it will use. I highly recommend playing around and testing with these settings to see exactly what your PC can handle. As I mentioned, if the resolutions are set too high, you might drop frames, which will result in a choppy stream or video recording. The Hotkeys tab allows you to set up your own hotkeys and shortcuts that you can use to do things like start the stream, run transitions, and more. Feel free to set these up as and when you want to. Finally, the Advanced tab has a variety of settings that you shouldn't need to change, but you might want to adjust them in the future. There's things like how it will name your video files. After closing the settings, you might now need to change some of the settings we looked at earlier, such as the audio mixer or the screen preview. If you change the resolution in the video settings, you will now need to rescale the preview by dragging the corners to fit the full screen. Once you're ready to start recording or streaming, you just need to use the buttons in the bottom right of the window. And so that is how to download, install, and set up OBS on a Windows 11 PC or laptop. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways you can speed up your Windows PC. That video might help improve the performance of OBS and allow you to record or stream in higher settings. Help support the channel by visiting the store. The link is in the description and at the end of the video. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below. And if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.